Hello everyone! I must warn you that this material is not for beginners who have totally no experience with vacuum tubes technology. So be warned, high voltages which we are going to operate can kill you. Also, to understand what we are going to talk about here today, you need a technological background and some experience with vacuum tubes technology and electronics in general. So this is not a tutorial for beginners. On the other hand, please forgive me some simplifications and not professional vocabulary, as I want to keep things understandable for those who are not professionals. I'm completely aware of different methods like fixed bias and auto bias, but what we want to achieve here is not to read a perfect characteristics of a tube, but to assess its condition for work in a guitar amp. You have probably come across the problem that your amplifier, be it hi-fi or guitar amplifier, have lost high tones, the sound became dull and dark, it got quiet or started to hum. The first thing you think of is worn-out vacuum tube. It gives you a choice. You can start changing the tubes way by one, which with 8 tubes in an amplifier can take a whole day, or buy a whole set, which is expensive. Or perhaps in your basement you discovered a treasure in the form of a bag of old tubes, but you do not know if they are any good. So let's say you are going to measure your tubes by yourself. You start checking the prices of automatic meters on the internet and it almost makes you fall off your chair. Eventually you can send your tubes to someone to do it for the money. But you don't watch my movie, so that someone does the job for you, right? So what makes a good 12AX7 or ECC83, which is basically same vacuum tube? Some will say emission, but electron tube manufacturers do not give such a parameter as emission. The value which really matters here is transconductance, often labeled as S. In simplification, as we try to keep things simple in this video, so please forgive me, it tells us how changes of the current inside the tube are dependent on changes of the grid voltage. Let's take a look at typical ECC83 application schematic. One of the methods is you apply a plate voltage between the plate of a tube and the ground of about 250 volts. And then choose a fixed voltage between the grid and the ground, example given minus 2 volts, and measure what's the plate current. This method is easier to do, but the values you find are less accurate since transconductance must be tested close to average plate current. It is a good idea to test the tube as it is working within target operating parameters, as in the circuit in which it's going to be used. Here we have a document for ECC83 from JJ, which is a European manufacturer of vacuum tubes. It says that typical transconductance is 1.6 milliamperes per volt. But important is that it must be measured for typical operational characteristics, which we can find here. So, for this particular tube, typical characteristics are plate voltage 250 volts, negative grid voltage minus 2 volts, anode or plate current 1.2 milliamperes, transconductance 1.6 milliamperes per volt, and typical gain is 100. You can see that on what so-called transition characteristics, for anode voltage of 250 volts and minus 2 volt grid voltage, anode current should be 1.2 milliamperes. Let's assume that maximum deviation of a plate current of a good tube is less than 30%. We want to measure corresponding grid voltage deviations and compare them with tube manufacturer's characteristics. What does that mean is that if we take typical plate current, which is about 1.2 milliamperes, 30% derivation from it is about 0.36 milliamperes. Now we need to calculate a grid voltage change corresponding to that value, which is. Therefore, for a good tube, our maximum plate current deviation is 0.36 milliamperes, or maximum grid voltage deviation is 0.22 voltage. But how to measure it without an expensive equipment? Well, actually, we already have it. It's our own amplifier. Let's take a look at some schematics. What we need are three voltages and a multimeter or two. A plate voltage, which is about 250 volts. A heater voltage, obviously needed by the tubes. And a grid voltage, which is the biggest problem here, as it has to be negative. Let's take a look into the schematic of the amplifier I have here. We can take plate high voltage from the amplifier's high voltage supply, which is here, or just before the anode resistor of any of preamp tubes and the ground, which is here. As for the heater voltage, we can take it from amplifier's stabilized heater current supply, which is here. Now, where to take negative grid voltage? Fortunately, this amplifier has a separate stabilized power supply for its effect loop buffer and a backlight PCB. We will use half of it to get minus 15 volts and use a potentiometer as a voltage divider to get minus 2 volts out of it. Do not be sad if your amplifier doesn't have this, because you can even use a 9 volt battery. Let's take a look at the final schematic. Here we have 350 anode voltage supply from the amp, which we are going to divide using P1 potentiometer and two resistors. We can do that only because the current is going to be low, so it will not heat up too much. We will use it to set 250 of plate voltage, which we are going to measure here. Here we have an ammeter, but we also need a switch here. The purpose of this switch is if you have only 1 meter, you close the circuit while the ammeter is not connected. Another thing we need is a switch, because ECC83 contains of 2 triodes inside and we want to measure only one at once. It's a double one to switch between anodes and grids of the tubes at the same time. And here we have another voltage divider, which we use to apply negative grid voltage while reading anode current. Now it's time to see how it works. As we said before, a proper solution would be to apply 250 to the plate and then adjust the grid voltage until you have 1.2 milliamperes of plate current. The average value should be 2.0 volts plus minus 0.36 milliamperes. But it's not that easy in our setup, because every time you change grid voltage, your plate current will change too. If you want, you can try that. But we only want to assess the overall condition of the tube. Therefore, what we are going to do is to set a fixed grid voltage of minus 2 volts and read what's the plate current. The first thing you need to remember is to make sure your heater voltage is within 5% accuracy of 6.3 volts. To do that, you will need to plug all tubes into your amp except one. If you won't do that, your heater voltage will go up and you are going to get much higher plate current readings, or eventually you can destroy your tubes. First, make an initial measurement of plate voltage and make sure it's exactly 250 volts. Now, set negative grid voltage to minus 2. This one won't be changing during the test. Read the ammeter, or if you have only one multimeter, switch it to ammeter mode, plug it in, and use the switch to open the circuit and make the current flow through ammeter. Let the tube heat up like this for about 10 minutes. You will observe plate voltage changing during that period. Make sure your negative grid voltage is still minus 2 volts. Set plate voltage to exactly 250 volts. Finally, read plate current. And that's it. You want to know if it is in the range of 0.36 milliamperes from 1.2 milliampere. Now, if you want to be more accurate, you can repeat the process for a few points on the transition characteristics. By changing negative grid voltage, read corresponding plate current, and draw points on the transition characteristics to check if they are on the curve drawn on the transition characteristics. If they are below the line, your tube needs replacement. That's all. Write down your measured plate current. If its value is far lower than 1.2 milliamperes, you need a new tube. If it's a little bit higher, your tube performs beyond expectations. If you have any questions, leave a comment, hit subscribe button, as there are going to be many much more exciting experiments, tests, and plenty of myth-busting on my channel very soon. Take care, stay safe.